his speech synthesis, the future of machines. We know that the machines are becoming more and more sophisticated these days. And so if there is no natural communication with the machine, it will be difficult to operate that machine. According to a survey, that 60% of the machines in hospitals are lying just in stores because doctors don't know how to operate those machines because they are so sophisticated. What button should be pressed, after what button, it is difficult. So even an educated person feels difficulty in operating the machines, then the sophisticated machine is of no use. So if there is a communication, there is a natural communication between the machine and us, then it will be very easy, very convenient even for us to operate that machine. So for communication, there will be two methods. Two senses are very important. One is the vision and second is the speech. And speech is better than the vision, because if there is any obstruction in between us and the target, then you cannot see the target. So, but speech can cross the obstruction as well. So speech is more convenient as compared to the vision. So here I will just go into the detail how speech can be generated and what is speech synthesis. So first, the definition of speech synthesis. Speech synthesis is the generation of speech by machines, but this is a very simple definition of speech synthesis. If you go to a platform, railway platform, you observe that some announcements are made that this train is going, this is coming, but if the person who recorded that passage is not available and you want to introduce some different train, then what will happen? One part of the sentence will be in the voice of one person and the second part of the passage will be in the voice of the second person. So there will be so much discontinuity that it will not be an appealing sound for you. So we have to adjust the dissimilarities between the speech portions so that we feel very appealing sounds even at railway stations or for any announcements. So this is one application which you commonly see at railway stations, but there are much more applications of speech synthesis. Some of latest applications I will discuss. So far, just a presentation overview has been divided into these sections. I will not just mention. So here are the vocal folds, how speech is generated. Actually, when we want to speak, we increase the pressure inside our lungs by just by forcing the diaphragm upwards, and because of that high pressure, thus the air flows from high pressure towards the low pressure, and a high velocity waveform is created in between the vocal folds. And you know, according to Bernoulli theorem, if the velocity is more, the pressure is less. So because of the less pressure, vocal folds starts in coming towards each other. And when they come when they close the vocal folds, there is no passage for the air to flow, and still the pressure is high below the vocal folds, they force the vocal folds to open, and because of their elasticity and mass, etc., they start vibrating with some frequency, and that is called the pitch of us. So for human beings, for actually male, the frequency is about 100 to 200 hertz, and for females, it is 200 to 400 hertz, and for children it may go about 400 to 600 hertz, and even for birds it is about 5000 hertz. So the DC, because if they don't vibrate, then there is a DC, and for DC we know that in electronics it cannot have any information. So for having the information, the signal must be converted to AC. So vocal folds convert that DC signal into AC, and that is further processed by the filter, which is composed of this nasal and oral cavity, and so that we have a filtered voice at the output, which we perceive. So here is our ear. How we perceive the sound. Actually, the pressure outside the ear is very low, and the pressure inside the ear, inside the cochlea, is very high. So variation in the air outside the ear cannot make the fluid, which is very dense inside the cochlea, to vibrate. So first, there must be some instrument in between the atmosphere and the cochlea, so that the very low pressure variations are converted in the high pressure variation. So for that, a transformer is there, then not electronic transformer, and mechanical transformer is there, impedance transformer, which is made using these three bones, and so the light variations of the pressures are converted to very high pressure variations, and the liquid inside the cochlea starts vibrating. And what is the purpose of cochlea there? Actually, cochlea is an electronic component which converts, which takes the Fourier transform of the time domain signal into the frequency transform, and that frequency transform goes to the brain, where each portion of the brain is sensitive to different frequencies, and we have some perception inside the brain, and we perceive what the person is trying to see. So it is the part of the brain which is sensitive to this. And again, I will not go into this detail. There are different types of voices, you know, vowels, consonants, semi vowels, liquids. But one thing just I want to say that we don't need the vocal folds for all type of sounds. Only these are the voice sounds which are created by the vibration of the vocal folds. For example, that is created by the vibration of the vocal fold. When you pronounce you feel some type of vibration here. But when you speak k, p, t, these are not voice sounds created by vocal. These are created by stopping the airflow at some point within our vocal tract. So when we stop the energy, then what will you perceive? Nothing. Because when you have stopped the energy, then nothing will come to your ear. Then what you are listening? So it is not the information you have stopped. So it is the information contained. When you release that stop, then the information comes into the eddy currents inside that portion of the speech, which is important for us. So the information just after the stop is very important. It is not the duration. So speech is very, very difficult to understand, because it is a very dynamic, very random, no special shape. Even a person, if speaks in the morning, if you record the in the morning, even if you record same in the evening, or even after 1 hour, the shape of the will change, the duration of the will change, many characteristics of the will change. Even if you speak the in this room or in different room, the characteristics will change. So it is so random signal that any formula does not work on this signal. So this is a very, very random signal. The quality of the voice depends upon what is the mass of your vocal folds, what is the frequency of your vocal folds, and how you make stops, and what is the shape of your this vocal tract, etc. So different configurations of the vocal tract articulates decide the speech quality. So how to generate the synthetic speech? Actually, people have tried many methods. For example, this is a mechanical device for generating speech. Naturally, speech output cannot be natural using this device. He is trying to modulate, simulate the mouth by just changing the shape of a tube. So and then presses this instrument, and it pushes the air through this modulated shape of the mouth, and it generates some sounds. Naturally, fricatives, many stops cannot be generated using this device, and the quality is very, very unpleasing. Again, another. So this was the first device, electronic device, used for generating the speech, and the size of this device was of the size of this room, and even operating this device was very, very difficult. Even the experts could operate this device. So training of 5-6 years is required to just just pronounce and one sentence using this device. So no person will use. So this is electronic synthesizers. Again, the quality is not very good. Again, many synthesizers. So, but there are two main approaches for generating the speech. One approach is that you record small sounds, and when you want to synthesize long passages, you concatenate those sounds, those small units of the sounds, and you generate good passage. But problem is again there. When you concatenate two different sounds very near to each other, the phase discontinuity is there. So because of that phase discontinuity, naturally the frequency domain, some type of distortion will occur at that point. And again, we know that the naturalness of the speech is conveyed by the pitch contour. How we modulate our vocal fold frequency, that conveys the actually emotions. So if you want to convey a different type of emotion, then you have to regulate the pitch contour of your speech very, very specifically. If pitch contour is not correct, naturally the emotions will not be communicated. For example, if you say, "Roko, mat jaane do, roko mat jaane do." Different, both sentences have different meaning. So just by slight variation in the time duration and pitch contour, the meaning of the sentences may change. That's why the shaping of the pitch contour is also very important for speech generation. So you have seen that using small units, we cannot generate good speech. So for removing discontinuities, there should be another method. For example, parametric models are there for generating speech. So we are working on harmonic plus noise model, which is a good model, and we are getting the speech quality so good that you will not be able to distinguish whether it is a original recorded speech or synthesized speech. So quality of our speech is very, very pleasing. And there were samples actually what we have generated and what is the speech output of other researchers, and but here I cannot play it. There are many applications of speech generation. For example, speech transformation. The speech of one person can be transformed to that of another person. What are the applications of this transformation? Many, many applications. For example, Tansen is not here and I don't have the voice of Tansen. So if I pronounce a rag in my own sound, if system is developed for transforming, then I can convert that raga to the voice of the Tansen, and the same effects would be synthesized. Okay, I'm not sure that this type of synthesis will ever be possible, but this is the distant application of the speech synthesis, that we would be able to generate the speech of any person, even who is dead, or even the Jawaharlal Nehru speech can be created. So any speech can be converted to that of another speech. This is the actually objective of speech transformation. And even for training, the person who feels difficult in listening also feels difficult in speaking, because the feedback mechanism is there. So for training these type of persons, some devices, gadgets can be made for pronouncing some sentences, passages, and even for speech therapists, these type of devices are used. Even for blinds, you know that if a blind is going crossing a road and he cannot see these light signals, traffic light signals, so his stick can have a communication small camera within it, and it will observe this light pattern, and according to that it can pronounce that it is red light, now you cannot cross, it is this blue light, or sorry, yellow light, it is green light. So this is also a very good application of speech synthesis. So again, for this blind people keyboards, these are also available in the market actually, but question is of speech quality and the pitch contour. The pitch contour is fixed. So if pitch contour is fixed, the emotions are not conveyed by these devices. So even though some devices are available, but again the pitch is fixed, so the emotions are not there. So again, cochlea, people who cannot listen, so we can generate some type of patterns and directly communicate those patterns to the cochlea. So cochlea will send those patterns to the brain and the person will be able to listen. So this type of research are also possible. So this is explained by this Manoj also, that people whose vocal folds have been removed because of injury or surgery, they have a hole here called soma and they breathe from here. If a people is breathing from here, then air is not passing, that this portion is sealed, so air is not passing through their mouth, so they can only make their different shapes but cannot speak. So if we have some mechanism of vibrating this portion, and or we can put the artificial larynx here, then some type of speech can be generated, but the speech quality is so bad that it is difficult even for the person who is speaking to guess what he is speaking. So what to talk about the person who are just in surrounding. Even these person cannot go outside their home, because you know that when you are eating and you want to speak something, and some particle, the food particle, goes to your air pipe, then what happens? And for these person, the hole is here. So direct connection of the atmosphere with their lungs. So even a very simple dust particle goes to their lungs, that will be very difficult. So these person don't try to come out of their home. Second problem is that because every time when we put this vibrator here, every sound, whether it is voiced or unvoiced, it will be voiced because vibrator will be there. And third problem is that the output is very noisy. And the next problem is that because if you make this device on for many hours, then the cost of the battery is about, for example, 20 rupees, 30 rupees. So per hour, spending 30 rupees for a poor person is difficult. And even the cost of this vibrator is about 35,000. And in forensic science also, if you want to identify a person by speech, naturally that can be done because each person has its distinct qualities or parameters or attributes in the speech. Even at the ATM, you have a 4-digit password. So even a hacker can decode 100-digit password. So what is a 4-digit password? So if you have a speech password, then that will be more authentic as compared to a digit password. So I won't go into detail. So there are many hardware devices available in the market. For example, very very cheap 256 IC is available. Using that IC you can generate speech. Again, the quality will be very very just machine quality, not natural quality. But in projects people use this type of. So this is a speech already available in the market. So I didn't have the time, so I won't go into detail. Thank you very much.